Clerks 2, one of the best sequels that did not need to exist. The first movie could have just been its own film with the two leads making cameos and a few other things. But 12 years later, we got an official sequel that, while not quite matching the first, is still a pretty damn good movie. That feels like how these two characters would have ended up. Dante and Randall, played once again by Brian O'Halloran and Jeff Anderson, have started working at a fast food restaurant called Movies after the quick stop burns down. Dante is about to be married to a woman named Emma, played by Kevin Smith's wife Jennifer for Smith, and it's his last day, and much like the first film, we get a day in the life of these two shenanigans. Along with that, we get stuff with Jay and Silent Bob, their boss Becky, played by Rosario Dawson, and their younger co-worker Elias, played by Trevor Fearman. So I think this movie does a good job of taking the feel of the first Clerks movie and bringing it into the 21st century. It's got a very mid-2000s aesthetic, but the plot structure, dialogue, the fact that it has random stuff happen that has little impact on the story, it all feels like the original. They'll just go off on random tangents about movies, and to bring it into the 2000s, this is all about the Lord of the Rings and the live-action Transformers movie that will be released the year after this movie came out. My god, this movie is 13 years old! But yeah, I absolutely love the Star Wars versus Lord of the Rings debate Randall and Elias get into. It is kind of a battle between the early Gen Xers and late Gen Xers slash early millennials. And even though the Lord of the Rings trilogy is great, I do think Randall sums them up perfectly.
Those fucking Hobbit movies were boring as hell. All it was a bunch of people walking. Three movies of people walking to a fucking volcano. Here's the first movie. And here's the second movie.
He is way off, loser.
You ready for the third movie?
Rewatching this recently, I was actually surprised how similar this was to that shitty Clerks pilot I reviewed as an April Fool's Day joke. I mean, Dante is still working there despite the end of the first movie saying he should do something more with his life. They added a new guy character with Elias, although to be fair, Elias is actually funny. It's almost like they watched that pilot and thought, oh, okay, we could do so much better than this. The movie isn't quite as good as the first. While it has more of a plot progression, it doesn't have the incredible relatability I felt to Dante in the first movie. I will say, I think this was overall funnier than the first movie. Oh yeah, there are some politically incorrect moments, but the dialogue and slapstick are really good, and it's just an overall fun movie and even had a dance number in the middle of it. I really like Dante in this, even if I don't relate to him as much as I did in the first movie. He kind of has the same flaw he did in that film, but it leads to a different problem. In the first, he was a pushover who would screw over himself by letting people walk all over him. In this, he's a pushover and his fiance starts controlling his life, choosing where he'll live, not letting him be involved in their wedding decisions, and having his home and job picked out for him. In the first, life was shitting on him, and in this, he's getting everything handed to him. Neither is really a life you probably want to live. And once again, he causes all his problems. Sure, Randall is kind of a douchebag, but pretty much everything bad that happens to Dante is due to his decisions. A main theme in the movie is getting older. They're both in their 30s, they're still working a lame job, their lives are going nowhere. It's that sort of crisis we all go through. And this is kind of a movie I appreciate more now that I'm older. Sure, I'm not that old, but recently I've been feeling like my life hasn't been going anywhere. I've had the same job for 3 years, I'm loaded with debt, I don't get out much. There's a scene in this where Dante and Randall see one of their old classmates, played by Jason Lee, who's now rich. This really hit me because it's bad enough feeling like my life is in a rut, but seeing on Facebook all my old high school and college friends getting new jobs, moving away, getting married, having kids, it just makes me feel worse because I feel like I'm supposed to have this stuff by now too. But this movie actually has a very good message. Who cares? I don't have to live my life to other people's standards. I don't have to do these things. Dante learns that lesson. I can't say exactly how because it's spoiler heavy, but it's made me think, yeah, why do I feel like I have to follow a specific life path? Because society thinks I should, or because I want to? Man, I'm getting way too personal in this video. Clerks 2 is a really great movie. It's got a lot of laughs, a lot of heart, a good message, and an ending that just leaves me feeling satisfied. It did seem like this is where these two characters would end up. I love it. Not as much as the first, but it's a really solid sequel and I give it a 9 out of 10. It was the movie that was supposed to end the Viewisk universe, but of course we're getting the new Jay and Silent Bob movie. But before that, Smith tried his hand in some different kind of films, and in 2008 brought us Zack and Miri Make a Porno, and we'll talk about that tomorrow. See you then.